29th Winter Universiade continues in the Siberian city of Krasnoyarsk, and in particular at this fantastic Biathlon Academy venue. And today it is the sprint competition for both women and men, with the women having gone through their rifle checks, and they are due to start shortly. Having a look here at some of those who will lead off, and also some of those who are considered favourites for this event. Minus 1.5. It really feels even warmer with the stillness, the dryness of the area, humidity at 36%. The wind direction, which of course is important, coming from the southwest, and does, we'll see that shortly, look a little bit... a bit of strength from the left for the shooters. We'll be led off by two Norwegians, Kittelsen and Hunsi. And then we get to the first of the Russians, that is Kaplinar, who will go off at number 7. The second group will be led by Mertsa. So there's 6 Russians, 4 from the Czech Republic and Canada, 3 from Poland, and 3 from Slovakia. At the 29th Winter Universiade begins with Hege Kittelsen from Lillehammer University of Applied Sciences. She leads away, and in 30 seconds time, her countrywoman Silja Hunsi will take off. Well, a little bit treacherous on that first minor turn. And here is Hunsi. So 3 laps, 2.5 kilometres, really is a nice downhill towards the end of this course, which we'll see later. And then deceptively a slight rise before they hit the finish line and, of course, the shooting range as well. We'll see how she negotiates that right-hand turn, no difficulty there. One of the favourites here, Kaplinar. She was 5th in the individual. And it gave herself a good chance, but let herself down on the range. She attends Sergat State University of Kanti Mansisk. I think she'll have a little bit to prove today. Huge roar goes up for the second Russian athlete. Now this group of Russians will be looking to make it 1, 2, 3 if they can in the sprint, as they did in the individual. She's ready to go from the University of Alberta. Canadians had named part of their team back in December, but extended the deadline so they could fill some more of the places, which they've done. Kaplinar gets the roar of approval from the crowd. Wearing the number 7 bib. She takes over that mantle of number 1. Now, a woman who was 4th in the individual. I would dearly love to move up a spot. The Russians have made a change to their starting lineup because the woman who finished 3rd is not starting. So Voronina now gets through very quickly, but with one penalty loop to complete. Zakovic. Ooh, shooting quickly. Whoa! Oh, it looked like she was in such good form, quickly and accurately, but missing that last one. So about a 25-second visit to the penalty loop area. A woman who won the women's individual 2 days ago, the opening event here at the 29th Winter Universiade, Natalia Gubolova, she will be again highly favored to win this. Coming out there is Kazakovic now out of the penalty loop. Back onto the course. The numbers don't mean much. Some are into their second lap. See here, this is Kaplina through the 4K. She has the fastest time, 11 minutes 48.2. Top Veronina also had a miss. Sato struggling. Oh, these two, number seven, number six. So seven is Kaplina, six is Gubolova. Out on the course, we just had a glimpse of Gubolova, who was the winner of the gold medal 2 days ago in the individual. So she's approaching the range. One miss for Vasnetsova. So they're all having their little periods of uncertainty. Here is the woman who is the favourite after winning the individual on day one, Natalia Gubolova. But even she has one miss, and that's from the prone position, so she visits the red zone. She starts her lap as others are leaving it. Vasnetsova of Russia there, number 27. So as they come out of the shooting area, number one, it certainly was Kazakovic who was leading. She's maintained that lead right through. Still several of them to visit the standing chute, amongst them Kazakovic. Here she is. Well, our leader, number 14, Kazakovic, for a while anyway. But the standing chute is proving a bit of a problem for some of the leaders. And she goes into that red zone and will be rueing the fact that she could not maintain her fine shooting standard from the previous visit to the range. Kazakovic from Russia. Well, three misses. It was almost as if her head started to drop a wee bit that time when we saw her. She was perfect through the first shoot. She maintained the lead right through. But after her standing shoot, it just let her down. She was the first of the Russians away. Kaplina now moves up with that strong climbing style of hers to get alongside Zabotova. Roars of encouragement for Elizaveta Kaplina from Russia at the 6.5. She's setting the pace. Now, well, what a challenge coming to from Voronina. just as strong on the climb, which takes them up to this split of 6.5. Kaplina was the fastest through. We saw her a moment ago, gritting her teeth, determined, chest heaving, and she gets through nicely. Moshkova to that 4 kilometer mark. This is where Kazakovich was leading. He looked to have control of the race. Now has lots of work to do and lots of threats. Kaplina. Huge roar for this woman from Sirgut State University. Fifth in the individual 2 days ago. Outstanding in any of the climbing work to be done. There wasn't much of it, but enough for her to push some pressure on the others. And here she comes to the finish now. Kaplina giving it everything. And the sprint women's title is possibly within her grasp. She has done everything possible. 23 minutes 48. Two misses. Given it everything. Another of the Russians. Well, she may well be in this medal count as well. She's going to be quicker. Quicker through that last stage. And there it is at the moment. Russia 1 and 2, but still lots of athletes to come in. And lots of them in a position of challenging. Into the range, still they shoot, still they visit that penalty loop. Vasnetsova now, Russia. Already two of their top athletes have finished. That massive advantage Vasnetsova had over Kazakovich at this stage. Oh, two misses for her. The clock was so much in her favour. Gubulova. Again, a massive advantage in time. If she... Oh, miss for her. Two. Three misses for Gubulova. And wow, the frown comes on her face and she does not relax. She has to thrash herself around that penalty loop area three times. Nothing is certain. Moshkova. She can take all the time she wants. If she nails these three, oh, just as I speak, needs this one. No, she keeps this event. Everyone on tenterhooks. It'll be right to the last competitors before we find out who's going to win this. Kazakovich, early leader. Kazakovich is the leader now. Well, around the course, she was quite sensational. But she made it difficult, as too has Gubulova. But she is so powerful. And this last lap, she will eat it up. The other skiers will wonder what's going on as she thumps up alongside and goes past them in her efforts to claw back the deficit. Up this hill. up to that 6.5 kilometer split. Looking to stay in contention here for a medal, and she will. She comes up to the check, so she's in third place. Well, she will probably get pushed out of that because there's such good competitors behind her. Natalia Gubulova, who takes which medal? Kazakovich, Voronina, Moshkova. Kazakovich at the finish is still a woman in front. Smetanova of the Czech Republic is fourth at the moment. Three Russian competitors yet to finish. Kazakovich leads. She is finished at 23.02. Up to the line, Vasnetsova, still with the downhill. Then the right-hand turn into the slight climb, and then home. So Vasnetsova, time running out for her, certainly to take the gold. Voronina. Well, she's just tenuously hanging on to that second place at the moment, Voronina, because there is still Gubulova, Moshkova still to come through. She's going to push Kaplina out of the medals for the moment. She does. Vasnetsova is in third, but it's back on the course we go. Natalia Gubulova. Oh, well, she's giving it everything. She gave it everything in those penalty loops. Now she thrusts to the line, and she comes into the medals in third place. Moshkova, what a performance from her so far. Just seemed to have it within her control. Now, can she get there? Is there less than 8 seconds for her? Will she hit the line before Kazakovich? And she does. Moshkova. Touch and go for her. Absolutely supreme through the first half of the race. Opened the door for the others on the range the second time. But her absolute power and skill, that determination has carried her to the line for victory in the women's sprint. Moshkova had one less penalty than Kazakovich, and yet she just got home ahead of her. 2.9 seconds. Wow. Hastur, Vinklakova, Sichon just with the one miss. And the only one to go through clear was Shovanova of Slovakia. Just two misses at the range for Veronina. And having finished fourth in the individual, she is the bronze medalist in the sprint. Right until the last couple of minutes, she possibly thought this gold medal might be mine. 2.9 seconds the difference between silver and gold for Irina Kazakevich. Misses in the standing shoot, and she might well have thought, I've lost this, but she kept it. Brilliant last lap of skiing for the gold medalist, Ekaterina Moshkova of Russia. Russia, 1, 2, and 3. So certainly the Russians continue to dominate the women's biathlon at the Winter Universiad. Our champion, Ekaterina Moshkova of Russia. Russia 1, 2, and 3. In fact, Russia 1 through to 6 in this biathlon women's sprint. Thank you for watching the women's sprint from Krasnoyarsk. Until the next time, goodbye.